Beautiful girl, you're a lovely picture. Beautiful girl, you're a gorgeous mixture of all that lies under those big blue skies. My heart cries, beautiful girl.
And here is the unholy three right here.
As
one, two, three.
So what's today's date is what?
February 3rd, 1990.
We're talking to John and Judith Wack about their wedding day.
Wedding day?
Yep.
We had the Elm Tree in Farmington, Connecticut, which was an old historical building, an old inn. And
we just ate dinner, drank, and that was it?
Uh-huh. Wheeled around.
No dancing.
How long did it last?
Oh, let's see, about...
I think it started around...
3 hours, I guess, 4 hours, you know.
The whole thing was over by dinner time?
By supper time, yeah. We left there late afternoon.
So who else was at the wedding? All Wack relatives and all Heffernan relatives?
Well, let's see.
Aunt Mabel came from Pickway. And
Bill Mertzweiler came
Bill Mertzweiler from Akron.
His high school buddy.
My brother Bill and Carol and
David.
Anybody in your family not come?
No, not really.
Everybody who you anticipated being there was there.
Dad in the rainforest, taking his leisure, halfway through the walk.
People who meet in this romantic setting.
Okay, aren't you going to say something for the camera?
By the lovely.
Well, first of all, where did you go on your honeymoon?
We went to...
Boston,
then from Boston we went up to Maine.
Oh, wings and legs.
We went along the coast of Maine up to Belfast.
Castine.
You remember anything in particular about that?
Oh, yeah.
It was so pretty. Beautiful.
And the crab soup. Lobster soup. It was so good.
This is in August.
This big bowl. It was.
I guess maybe Maine is still the same way. I don't know. We have been up on those back roads, but there it wasn't like you were on the East Coast when you got up there. If you didn't eat by 6 o'clock at night, chances are you weren't going to find a restaurant open. You had to really watch
the time,
the traveling, and the time.
But Rangeley was beautiful at that time. That time of year. Oh, but we went to the Rangeley Hotel.
What happened?
That was one of those old, tiny, white, clabbered, big old things.
Big. Sits on the end of the lake.
And it's all filled with these old people, you know, who've been coming
60,
there for
35
years or something.
And we ate, and it was a full silver.
And you guys were the only young people there?
Right.
And everything, yeah. We went out into the parlor, which was a big room. And they had a string quartet.
Uh-huh.
And these old women were all around the string quartet, sitting there dozing. And it was just right out of an English movie or something. And we started giggling. We couldn't stop laughing. We couldn't stop laughing. The whole thing was a big caricature.
So how long was your honeymoon total? A couple weeks, it sounds like.
Yeah, I think we were... days, something like that.
Almost 2 weeks,
Because you had to get back to start college teaching.
Right.
Come on, overtake them. Dear, you're not supposed to leave the room when I'm taking your photograph.
Oh. I'm coming back in now.
Did you dwell on the curtain?
Oh no, I really must get the curtains. Veronica's handiwork. Beautiful.
So how soon after you got back did you move in here in Parker Terrace?
Well, we moved into a little apartment on Webster Street.
Yeah.
If you ever go down that way, there's a whole bunch of small brick apartment houses.
Right,
in there.
Right.
And we had a little second floor flat, and it was small. And we lived there until spring.
Till April. We moved in here in April of...
So not that long.
54.
About 7 months, 8 months.
So April of 54. And so, and when did you have Mary?
In July.
July.
She used to get car sick very easily.
Very easily.
Huh.
She still gets air sick. She took Dramamine coming across. Whose wedding when Mary got sick in the car coming over to the wedding?
Remember? I think that was Bill.
She threw up in the car?
In my back pocket, leaned over the on the way to the wedding.
Car sick or was
she
sick?
Car sick.
She was about 3 years old or something. Yeah. She was probably all excited.
Yeah.
She's an excitable kid?
She used to anticipate things.
Yeah.
She wasn't normally, you know, excitable. She was very lively.
Uh-huh.
Her baby reminds me of the way she was when she was a baby. All that shouting and constant activity and looking around and everything. Very alert. But she was very happy, laughing all the time.
So Mary was born in July of 1954.
Right. So I worked until we moved out here at Family and Child Services.
In D.C.
In D.C. And your father was teaching at Howard, and we had one car.
So how did you get around?
Well, when we moved out here, that was the thing. It was
You quit when we moved out here,
right?
Didn't you? Yeah.
Because it was just going to be, there was no public transportation. This was really country out here. Then when we first moved in here, you could look across the field, across the street, and look over at the Naval Hospital.
It was clear. Just, you could see the Naval
Hospital. Oh, really?
Uh-huh.
The triangle. Nothing was built on the triangle.
Right.
Nothing. There was nothing across there, in front of us here.
Uh-huh. And the Naval Hospital, when was the Naval Hospital built?
Oh, 40s, 30s, late 30s.
Before the war, I guess,
huh? Yeah.
Now look at Mount Shasta. He saw the sign. But there are some other things interesting in the valley, too. Some old extinct volcanic cones. See some lava flows. This is down through the Central Valley, right below the Oregon line.
Wasn't there a summer when there was like you guys were invaded with snakes or something?
Yes.
Ooh. When was
big
that?
Big black snakes. That was when Tom was maybe 3 years old.
Yeah. These were big snakes.
Mary was probably in kindergarten.
And just that one summer.
4 or 5 foot long. No, everybody, all the kids in the neighborhood started chasing them, shooting them with BB guns and that. They climb trees.
The snakes?
Yeah. And went right up the tree. Just amazing. I've never seen a snake up a tree.
Well, that year we had the snakes. One of them was on our patio. And I went out after supper. And I had a cup of coffee in my hand. And I was just about to sit down at the picnic table. And Tom says, "What's that?" And I looked down, and there was the snake. I just jumped up on the picnic table and left him down there. Cowardice. Total cowardice.
How old was Tom?
That was about 3. Take care of yourself, kid.
So what did Tom do?
He just moved out of the way, I screamed and he ran away. It was a harmless snake, you know, it wasn't going to do anything to anybody.
Were you home, Dad?
Yeah, it was after supper, you were there.
That's when we started to chase.
Chase him?
Yeah, when I remember we ran around and went out. The black racers, eastern black racers.
The snake was probably more scared than we were.
Yeah.
So you think that all that persecution wiped them out? I mean, how come we never saw any black snakes?
Well,
after
I think
that?
Everything changed. The rabbits were gone. You know, the small rodents that they eat.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
So the whole environment got changed.
Right.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. Saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Ooh, yeah.
I think we got just about everything we need right here now.
So, alright, I guess that's enough for now.
Yeah. Pick it up next time. Pick another period.
First chapter of the Wack Chronicles.
Mm-hmm.
Liz, you want to say anything?
No.
Probably after I go to bed, I'll think of all these entertaining stories.
We'll do that, and then we'll
I will
do this again. All right, say goodbye.
Bye.
Good night.